mentor or is there anybody that you have your eye on that you're kind of trying to help to get to where you're sharing some of your knowledge? Is there any like new groups?
Honestly, if you see the show, you're going to see he working with his little homies. I got my little homies, he got his little homies. So you're going to see all that's really gravitating to somebody that some type of inspiring to us, but we can see us in them.
We see something these artists that reminds us of what we used to be. And it's just that little bit that it takes, you know what I'm saying, just to get them over the hump. So that's what we really doing for.
That's that nigga. With social media now and all these outlets, I really think, you know, nigga be talking about, I want to send you a demo. Man, you got too many ways that I can find out about you, but we stay on this interview, that's the new way.
Yeah.
I just think that niggas gotta stop having excuses and just go for it.
I mean, for me, as a producer, you put all your money back. You know what I mean? Like, when I made records that y'all listened to without even me owning the equipment.
Yeah.
I just was in my head. I go tell somebody, like, yo, I need you to do this, or I need you to do that. And what forced me to become more of a producer that I am is that they weren't listening to me. Like, I was telling them, like, yo, sample this, or sample this, and they'd be like, man, you gonna get sued, or they gonna take your money. And I'm like, I don't got no damn money. Like, talk about in an early stage. Like, matter of fact, me and Snoop had a song that was on Criss Cross album. We couldn't get it cleared because I think it was a sample of other things involved. But it was like, I never cared about that type of stuff. And you know, machines and all of that, all equipment that, like, if I got like $15,000 when I was like 15 or something like that, I think. I spent every dime of that on equipment. Not 1 cent came to like anything. Clothes or nothing. I wanted all my equipment. I needed the new keyboards. I wanted a new drum machine. And all I kept remembering that when I was like 13, I had to put a drum machine on layaway, and it wasn't for $250.
Layaway?
Yeah, it wasn't for $250. They got layaway deals for anybody out there that don't know.
That's a good tip. That's a good tip.
Not being a leader, being a follower. I'm not sure what a leader. I would have handled certain issues differently. It's delicate because it was a fine line. And it's like I come from a gangbang background where loyalty is rare and it's a must. And at that time, I was riding with my gang. And my gang was wrong. Whatever it was about, I was about whether it's right or wrong. And I knew it was wrong. So now that I know the difference, it's my job to speak on something that was wrong and stand for most of it.
I didn't study the craft. I didn't know what I was getting myself off into. I didn't know the business. I knew how to rap. We knew how to rap. We knew how to hustle. We knew how to do all that. But I didn't know the business aspect of it. I didn't know the broads, the publishers, the marketing. I didn't know none of the backfield game. I only knew the front end. And that's what they keep making records. So a lot of mistakes that I made, and understand, I'm the hot show. This is my brand. This is me and my brother label. All my little homies signed to me. You understand me? So, and I'm dealing with these big fishes up in New York. You understand me? Who know the game, been master of the game. They 45th on me. I'm 19 years old, straight out of the project with $30 million. So, and I didn't know. So I advise anybody, when you're getting in this game, because everybody want to get in this game, know this game, know what you're getting yourself into, study the crap.
It's no instructions based on what we did or what we doing. So you walking into stuff and you doing stuff, and the only thing that you can use to your, for me, the only thing I can use to my defense was to be cocky about the records that I was making. And at some time, like it's even like what Snoop was saying, sometimes, you know, that cockiness, you gotta let that go. And you gotta know when, if you fight with somebody, you gotta know like how far to take the fight before it becomes really a bad situation.
Superstar have to have a full package. Intelligent, smart, have know-how, probably 9 times out of 10, they read a lot, they up to date on everything, and just a smart person. You understand me? To be super creative in this game and to last long. Anybody could get money. It's how long you keep the money. You understand me? So with lasting long in this game, that's what makes a superstar. And it comes with knowledge. gotta have to be able to get along.
I think for me, it's just the belief. You know, a lot of times I talk to a person, artist, and I ask them, you know, and the first thing they say is, man, I can't believe I'm here with you. Right? To me, that's not
waste of time.
That's not a good sign for me. You know what I mean? Because, right. I mean, just for me, I might be different, but people ask me questions like, yo, did you ever think you was going to date Janet Jackson? I say, yeah.
Did you?
I can get anybody. I always thought that. The way I think, I'm just saying like,
you think big.
I just think like that. I always thought like that. I thought that, you know, I could do something. You know what I mean? Like Crisscross was not music when I saw them. I saw them walking through the mall and I was like, if they get a record, they gonna be the biggest group in the world. I saw it before I even made the record. You know what I mean? So my belief system is just, that's what I believe. You gotta believe you're a star. If you don't believe you're a star, you ain't gonna be no star.